Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers out there, I'm actually forced to make another compilation video. I did a video on the Bible and on all the Bible changes, and the lo and behold, that it's disappeared from my thing. It's gone from my videos. I go to the comments and go to my videos, and I noticed this a little while ago because I was expecting some family comments because I'd uploaded it to Facebook and shared it on Facebook with my family. Now, the video is no longer here. It was the video after this one. It was there this morning. Okay, whether or not it's some kind of Mandela effect or whether or not it's YouTube, the strange thing is it has vanished from Facebook as well. It's vanished from my folder. And I can't fucking believe this, folks. I really can't. It was here. And it said Mandela effect Bible changes. And it's not there. It ain't there. The video I made is vanished again. And it's strange. Like this one here. My ad went missing on Gumtree earlier. And I made a video. Yet it vanished. I did upload. It's still here in this file. Whether or not it's some kind of electronic shit is going on, I don't know. But whatever it is, it's starting to actually get a bit cheesy. It's sort of to see these things just vanish. And it's not the first one that vanished. This one had to be re-uploaded because it vanished. Still was in the thing, but it vanished from YouTube. Whether or not YouTube is trying to suppress the Mandela effect, I don't know. I don't know what the fuck's going on, but something's going on. And it's really, truly pissing me off, folks. It's sort of, I'm at the stage where I'm actually pissed off because I spent a lot of time making that, the one about the Bible changes, and yeah, it's no longer there. So I've got to remake the video again. So those of you that don't like the Bible, okay, and I know there's some of you that don't like reading scripture or don't want to hear anything about it. I'm going to talk scripture in this because it's quite strange. There are a lot of Bible effects that are taking place, and they need to be brought forward. And what I'm going to do in this video, I'm not going to so much read the scriptures, but to just tell you what scriptures they are that have been changed, and hopefully they allow it and don't rip it off, because somewhere along the line my video is gone missing. Okay, now those of you that don't have a Bible, go and get a pen and paper. I'm going to give you a few seconds to do that, and at least write these scriptures down. Then go and get the oldest King James Version you've got in your house. The oldest old King James Version of the Bible you got, whether it's 200 years old, grab that one, because you're going to find that the scriptures have changed within the book. Okay, Isaiah 11:6 is used to say, "And the lion will lay down with the lamb." It now says, "And the wolf will lay down with the lamb." Now, Luke 17:34. Okay, Luke 17:34. Okay, it used to say, "There shall be two in a bed, and one will be taken, the other one left." Now it says, "There will be two men in a bed, one will be taken, and the other one left." Okay, those of you that think, okay, I've got nothing against homosexuals. I've got friends that are homosexuals, and yeah, they're everywhere. It's sort of, and I'd have nothing against them, never have. One of my best mates, when in my younger days, was that way inclined. Now here's another one. There is Luke 19:27. "Bring here those enemies of mine who did not want me to reign over them, and slay them before me." Now Christ never said that. And then Luke 19:23, When did you not put my money in the bank? And that my coming, I have collected it with interest. Okay, the word bank has never been in the Bible. Okay, so we've got Isaiah 11:6, Lion and Lamb. We've got Luke about the two men in the bed. We've got Luke 19:27, and we've got Luke 19:23. Okay, there's another one. Matthew 21 verses 6 to 8. Matthew 21 verses 6 to 8. I don't think I've got it marked in this one. No, yes, I have. Verses 6 to 8. Well, that's the one talking about the ass. Okay, and it talks about the donkey in this one. In the New King James, it says donkey. In the Old King James, it says ass. And the colt. Okay, the word cult has never been in the Bible, not in that scripture. Okay, now, the word stuff appears in the Bible a lot now. Okay, Genesis chapter 31, verses 36 to 37, Genesis 45, chapter 17 to 20, Exodus 22, verse 7, Joshua chapter 7, verses 10 to 11. 1 Samuel chapter 10, verses 21, 22. 1 Samuel 25, verse 13. Ezekiel chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. Luke chapter 17, verse 31. And there's a ton of more. And I'm going to flip through my comments because they've been appearing in my comments. Everyone's had the nicety to throw them down. And the strange thing is, the comments are there. I know the comments are there. I saw them a moment ago. And people have commented on the video. But the video is... Okay. Comments have vanished now. Okay, now this is weird as well. Because the comments were there. An hour ago, the comments were still there. So, I don't know what's going on, folks. I really, truly don't. Yeah. This is a fucking joke, and it really is. I'm sorry, I'm tired tonight, guys. I'm absolutely exhausted. I've got a really bum knee today. The knee is playing up a bit because the weather is a little bit heading towards the cold, and that's generally when I get all these problems. But the fact that the video has just vanished, not just from here, this is the strange thing. It's not just, this is a Mandela effect happening as we speak. It's not just vanished from here, folks. It's vanished from Facebook, and it's vanished out of this folder. And that's what really gets me, is it could not have vanished out of this folder. There's no friggin' way it could have vanished from this folder. It was there. It said Mandela effect, Bible changes. And I put it and even pasted it, shared it on Facebook for my family, so my family would start to see the Bible changes. So those of you in the family, look at these changes. Those of you that know the Bible, and some of you don't get into it that much, I know, but some of you do. I strongly advise you to look at this book. These are changes. Whether or not this is a satanic deception, and it could be, the fact that that particular video is just vanished, could be a satanic deception. It could be something in the search engine when you mention this. And a few other people have mentioned that stuff has gone missing. I've got, like, has anybody noticed keys just vanishing for a day and then all of a sudden turning up? One of my permits went vanished, totally vanished, and then just magically appeared again the other day. A lot of this sort of stuff is happening, but my video, I spent an hour into making, an hour into uploading, and an hour into saving it. It took an hour to save the damn thing. It was like all these videos take me an hour at least to save, and then that, if not more, to upload. Sometimes I know this one here took nearly 2 hours to upload. Anything about an hour long takes me 2 hours to upload because, as you can see, they're all in HD. And the thing is, it's sort of like I've had missing time. I've had, oh God, I my whole life has been turned upside down. But these are the latest things. And as I said in one of the other videos, I believe that these ripples are happening and they're ripples in the reality. It's a ripple coming through. As if 1 minute something is like one thing and something else is like the other. And I just can't fucking believe it. And I'm sorry I'm swearing, folks. I really am, because this is just freaky deaky shit. And it is. It's freaky deaky. It's fucking weird. Like 1 minute something's there and something, then it's gone. Like my keys were in one spot one day. But the freakiest thing, here's one thing, right? This is a couple of days back it happened. I went to go to the loo. My toilet's no longer in that room. It was in the laundry. It's back in that room again, back in the same room again, the original room. And for 3 days, it was in another room. It was in my laundry, which is weird as all crap. It really is, folks. It's scary. It is scary shit. Something is going on. And I mean something... I don't know what the fuck's going on, folks. I really don't. I've got to throw my hands up in the air and say, Okay, I don't know what the fuck's going on. Okay? Have we shifted in reality? Is this a satanic attack? And it could be a satanic attack. Okay? The devil could be trying to mislead us. Every electronic map, everything that can be changed in the past has been changed in the past to make us think everything's different. It could just all be the same. Like minor changes, like to my harbour, could have been done back in time. He's gone back in time and said, well, got a job somewhere in the council or in the planning commission, and said, oh, no. Well, if you don't do it like this, it'll happen like that. And it could have caused that to happen. That could explain that. That could be a time variance. But there are other things that are happening in reality that are just too freaky to understand. All the map changes, yes, could be a time thing. Is he using CERN? Has he worked out a way to do this? And so, yeah, you've got to work out what's going on, folks, because to me, this is even freakier. It's sort of like, here I am. I put 3 hours into this bloody video, and it's gone. I've got to re-upload my video to YouTube, and I've got to remake the video, which is this video I'm making now, and I've just gone over the scriptures. Like, I went through and I read the scriptures out and everything like that. I was being a good little Christian boy and reading the scriptures out. Yes, I believe in God. Okay, I swear. I drink. I have a beer. I go out drinking with my mates. My pastor calls it working in the field. Okay? And because I went to him and I said, oh, pastor, look, I swear too much. Even in church, you've heard me swear. And he said, yeah, I know, I've heard you swear a few times. But he said, Tony, we all look at it like this, and all my congregation, the church that was mine, which is different now, it's got a different name, which I've only just found out today because I went to ring him up. And the thing is, it's sort of, my pastor used to say to me, Tony, he said, look, if you're in China preaching the gospel over in China, you'd speak Chinese. If you're in Japan, you'd speak Japanese. He said, Tony, you preach the gospel no matter where you go. If you go into a pub, you preach the gospel. You talk to your mates about God, and you always do. I know what you like. And I do. Yeah, my mates know it. I always talk about God because I love God. And I try and show people in the ways that God still loves me, no matter even if I'm sitting there playing a game of poker. He still loves me. And I make him know it. And so he said, Tony, look, he said, you go into pubs and clubs and everything, and you talk their language. And he said, call it pubbies. So like Japanese and Chinese, you talk pubbies. You still believe in God and you still preach the gospel. And I do. I preach it in a weird and wonderful way that no one actually knows that I'm doing it. Because I generally push the fact that I used to run the strip show, and then all of a sudden I re-found God and all this. And people sit back and shit. Go shit like this, and I swear, okay, I swear, I say fuck, I say the C word sometimes, yeah, try to avoid that one as much as possible, because even in bad, like, for my society, it's not, that one's frowned upon, mostly the women frown upon that one, but the thing is, it's just me, it's the way I am, and if everybody notices too, I fix the volume problem. Yes, I did actually find out what it was. It was actually my computer, not my microphone. It was my computer. I have two little things. I've got this program called, which I didn't know existed on this computer. So yeah, this is what the problem was with my speech. And if I can get it up, was this little bloody program here. For some unknown reason, the record volume, and you're going to notice the sound go down, was down here somewhere. And I didn't even know this program existed on this computer. Normally, I just use the other one. So as you can see, it's back up. It has been fixed. I apologize very much. I thought it was YouTube screwing around with me. But it was this little program interfering. So it's fixed. It's over. And the sound problem is being totally eradicated. So, yeah, those of you that believe in the Bible, you've got to turn around and you've got to look. And you've got to go and read these scriptures, guys. You really do. I'm going to state them out now. So I'll give you a couple of seconds. Go and get a pen and paper. Okay, you need a pen and paper. Write them down. These have changed, guys. And this is no fucking joke. It really is no fucking joke. You've got to write them down. Okay, and yes, I'm swearing. I'm sorry. Okay, it's just swearing too much has made me swear. Okay, Isaiah 11, verse 6. It's about the lion and the lamb is now wolf and the lamb. Luke 17, verse 34. Luke 19, 27. Luke 19, 23. That one's about the bank in the Bible. Matthew 21 verses 6 to 8. Then we've got all the stuff references, which is Genesis 31 verses 36 to 37. We've got Genesis 45 verses 17 to 20. It's actually in 20, but I think my mate just wanted me to read the Bible a bit. Exodus 22 verse 7. Joshua chapter 7 verses 10 to 11. And guess where it is? It's at the end. Okay, 1 Samuel chapter 10 verses 21-22. 1 Samuel 25 verse 13. Ezekiel chapter 12 verses 1 through to 3. Luke chapter 17 verse 31. Now, more and more of these have shown up, but unfortunately I can't tell you what they are. Now I'm going to put out the same thing I asked everybody in the last video. If you watched the last video, please acknowledge that I put it up, or is this just another bloody Mandela effect? Because I'm sure some of you told me I saw scriptures appearing left, right, and center in the thing, and then all of a sudden the video just vanished. And please re-put them into this video. I'm going to write them down. As soon as I get them this time, I'm going to write them down. Okay, those of you that think, save this video, okay, just in case they do this again. I do not know whether this is YouTube or whether it is not. But this has been, to me, a Mandela effect, because the fact that it's missing from here, but it's the fact that it's missing from here that freaks me out the most. It is not there. Okay, I'll go through them. One part there. No, that's not it. That's not it. That's not it. Not it, not it, not it, not it, not it. Bang, 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 bang. Again, not it. Nowhere to be seen. It's vanished again. Okay, so I don't know what's happened. Okay, all I know, I linked my family to it on Facebook. It's not on Facebook anymore. It's just vanished off Facebook. The strange thing is I linked two Bible verse videos to Facebook. They have vanished. Okay, there's only two people that can take them down, Facebook or me. I didn't take them down. So it's either Facebook or a Mandela effect has happened. I don't know if it's a ripple. I don't know. This is just freaky deaky crap. Okay, you've got to turn around and you've got to work out what's going on, because this is getting weirder and weirder by the day. And it's not as if we got hit with the Mandela effect and they stopped. It's actually quite the opposite, right? And actually, this is weird. I had, like, on most of my videos, most of them were over 100. Most of the comments were over 100. So I don't know what's going on. So, yeah, so something, and this is just something else, okay? I'm going to monitor my videos on a regular basis now. It's not just the comments. I'm going to monitor videos because this is just too fucking weird. And it's getting weirder and weirder by the day. And, oh, yeah, I noticed a couple of ladies commented on my video. And I just got to let you know. I'll actually see if I can find you. Today, YouTube. And let's see. Yeah, see, there it is, Bible Changes. Oh, I never thought of that. And I didn't fucking remove it. I didn't fucking remove it. There's the video there. It says that it's there, but it's saying I fucking removed it. I didn't fucking remove it. It's weird. This is really, really, really fucking too much for me as far as I'm concerned. But it's there. It's there in my history. Okay, and then I think I put it, but it's not there. So it's there in the history. Okay, they most probably forgot to do the history. I've got a funny feeling there's some electronic interference going on, folks, whether they're raiding my computer. These lovely ladies here spun me out. I watched their videos. So cool. So cool. And you've got to watch them. Segment Speaks. Yeah, they're funny as buggery. They actually made a comment on one of my videos here, this one here. But ladies, you got it wrong. I actually had 5 children in the other reality, okay? Just going to stop them here, and they're into the Egyptian stuff. Yeah, they're pretty cool, but it looks funny as hell. I've actually already subscribed, ladies, by the way, as you can see. And here I am. I left them a little okay, yep. Thanks. Thanks, girls. Oh, yeah, well... Here I am. I'm actually commenting on you. And trust me, folks, subscribe to these girls. They'll make you laugh. Any of you that are into the Mandela effect, they're not so much into that just one thing they've commented on my video. But the thing is, these two girls just made me laugh. They took away the hassles of what's going on and just made me laugh. And funny as hell. Yeah. Watch them. Sub to them. They'll make you laugh. Dead set. I've watched a few of their videos now. And I've just cracked it, and it has taken it away. And, so girls, guess what? Oh, I've had another Mandela effect. So, yeah, that one, that little message is for you. Yeah, video's gone missing now. So, yeah, sub to their channel, folks. Segment Speaks. Watch this particular video. That's one that we're mentioning me. But, yeah, ladies, you rock too, by the way. It's what I think is so cool. And I've watched about 3. I've watched that one. That one's a good one too, the Blue Moon one. They speak their mind like me. They're Aussies like myself. So, yeah, go for it, guys. Keep up the good work. Get the word out there. So, okay, folks, going back to what's happening. Something weird is not right. It's just fucking weird. And the thing is, okay, there it is in my history. The fucking thing is there. It's there. But why is it saying I didn't fucking remove it? I know I didn't fucking remove it because it was in here as well. And yet it's no longer in fucking here as well anymore. It's gone. It's fucking vanished. It was in here. I know it was in here because I snagged the program I'm using now to make this video. Something strange is in the state of Texas. Something strange is in the state of YouTube is more like it. And, I've heard of YouTube sort of doing this in the past, but I don't know whether this is a Mandela effect or whether this is what it is. But the thing is, this just should not happen, folks. That should just not happen. And I wonder, are the videos still up, comments still up in here? Might be, no. See, they've vanished from here as well. They've vanished from here as well. Oh, hang on. No. Bible Changes, yeah, so someone commented here. Okay, so yeah, there's comments. Okay, oh, thank God for that. I've got a couple of scriptures. So Luke 20:24, Luke 6, verse 1. Okay, so I'm going to get them out there by, I think, Romans 5:4. Okay, so they still exist. The comments still exist. So I don't know what's going on. I think this one might be a YouTube thing. And a lot of people over the years have been saying YouTube takes down their videos. Are they Mandela effects? I don't know. I do not know what's going on, folks. All I know is our world is no longer the fucking same. And it's not. It's different. It's really fucking weird. Everything is weird. Country change is weird. Everything is weird. And the thing is, you've got to turn around. You're going to have to cope with it, guys, because we could be friggin' stuck here. And I don't know. I really don't know what is going on. I wish I knew. I really do. I'm bewildered. And there's no other word for it, folks. I'm sort of thing. Now, to those half-wits out there saying, oh, well, you should be concentrating more on your three missing kids. Well, guess what? They don't exist in this reality. I've looked. I've done everything I can. The government registers say they don't exist. They never were born. Okay? My exes don't know me. Okay? My ex that had the child with me, a friend, right? Said we had the one-night stand, but we never had a child. So there, that's your question answered. So stop fucking saying it, okay? I'm getting fucking sick of it, okay? I'm sorry, and this is supposed to be about the Bible, but yeah, I'm pissed off about these idiots, okay? My three children in this reality were not born. They just weren't born, okay? They didn't come into existence here in this reality. They are still alive in my original reality, and that's the only way I can handle it, okay? And I'm just getting sick of these idiots saying, oh, well, you should be concentrating more on your three missing kids. They're just being trolls, okay? Well, guess what? You've got to, you can't learn and you can't cope. I'm very experienced with death. I come from an extremely large family, extremely large. One of the biggest families so much in our hometown that my grandmother used to be always in the papers for being the grandmother with the most grandchildren and like relatives. It's sort of, it's that large. Okay. We were public figures when my grandmother was alive because she was the matriarch of such a huge family. And yes, unfortunately, because of a huge family, death comes into it a fair bit. And hence I've learned to cope with death from a very young age, very young age. So yeah, the fact that my three children weren't born here is not as bad as losing someone through death. I know they're still alive in my reality, so please stop making these comments. Okay? I'm just getting sick and tired of it. I really am. You've got to understand that I'm stuck here. Okay? I'm a traveler. As far as I'm concerned, I'm a traveler from another reality. And whether you like it or not, I'm stuck here. Okay? Pleased to meet you. I'm from another reality, okay? Learn to cope with it, because we're here. There's billions of us here. Okay, some people saying it's only the English language. Trust me, I've spoken to a couple of Russian friends that have said, yes, the changes are in their Bibles as well. The old King James and the new King James Version in Russian have changed as well. They've changed in every single language as far as I know. I've had comments from people stating they have. Okay, so you've got to understand that these changes are real, folks, and they're happening. Okay, and unfortunately, this video is not as good as the last one. It's not as religious as my last one. They won no white. So, yeah, I do think there could be a demonic cause in this. And, yeah, it could be the Morning Star trying to get his last blast. Because it says in the last days that he's going to run wild and deceive the whole world and let the whole world think that he is God and let so many miracles and changes and different things. And, yeah, like all these magicians that can fly, yeah, using the demonic powers. And that's all it is, walking on water, like doing Christian miracles and everything is magic. And, yes, some people say, oh, it's just a glass under the water. What does he call it? Oh, I can't think of his name now. I'm not going to give him anything. But he gets ripped off the river by cops. And they are amazed at him doing it. And the thing is, it's sort of, he's just trying to mimic what Christ did. So, yeah, Christ said, I'm not going to show you any more miracles. He said, Christ is only coming back for judgment. That's it. The only one that's going to perform miracles and wonders is the morning star trying to get all your attention. So don't be deceived by the morning star, folks. The morning star is the devil. The morning star is powerful, yes. He's just as powerful as Christ. And unfortunately, God gave him too much power and he tried to replace God. So God kicked him out of heaven for the disbelievers in God. But someone said to me, and brought my attention to it, and I'm aware of it, a lot of these people that are recognizing the Mandela effect are Christians or believe just a touch in God. And I'm tired because I've got to make this video again. Normally I'd be asleep now, but the thing is, it's just weird as all crap, folks. A lot of stuff is going on. We don't know what it is. We don't know what to do. Hold on to those that are around you. Love the ones that are around you because they could be your family for the rest of your life. We could be stuck here. I don't know. Many of us are trying to find ways. Many of us are trying to contact scientific contacts. I am, myself. I've spoken to a medical practitioner. I've spoken to different things. And my medical practitioner friend turned around to me and said, Tony, he said, look, mate, he said, we've been told we're not allowed to say anything. And they're not. My GP's been going to a lot of conferences in the last couple of weeks, going to a few more in the next. They know. They know what's going on because some of them have come across, and I think they were called into all these different things. And I've seen the demonic symbol appear here and there and everywhere. And yes, I've seen the symbol appearing everywhere. So it could be demonic, folks. I don't know. It's up to yourselves. This is going to be a short one tonight, folks, because I'm tired. So I love yous all, and I am working on the website. That's one of the reasons I'm tired. And as I said, any of you that have any ideas for what we can put into this website, yeah, please let me know, okay? I'm very interested, and I'd like some input from some other people as well. And as soon as I've got it up and running, I'll let you all know, but yes, hold fast to what you have, folks. Love the ones around you. And look, honestly, if you're freaking out, if you are in my situation where you have had family removed, think of this. Your family are still alive in your original reality. Hold fast to that and it will help keep you sane. Because this is freaky, guys. And I mean, it's fucking freaky. And that's all we can do. I love yous all. And I'll catch yous all later. See yous. Bye. And to those new earthers, hi from the other side of the galaxy. Bye.